shall be constructed in our finest shipyard by our most skilled craftsmen. The great Leviathans acting as ambassadors for the Empire.
British ships built with American money. Whatever's the world coming to?
That's not for the likes of you and I to wonder, James. I don't suppose either of us will ever be privileged to travel in such magnificent surroundings. That's another day done, James.
Another long day indeed. They were not talking late tonight.
Great affairs, James. Great affairs.
Always that way when Mr. Ismay dines with his lordship.
I should think so. His lordship and Mr. Ismay are eminent men. Harley and Wolf is the world's greatest shipbuilder, and the White Star line is the jewel of the Atlantic services. Titania rules the waves.
I hear Cunard is faster now.
It's a matter of speed, James. Not for Mr. Ismay's passenger.
Gentry always don't they have time on their hands.
I will have none of that talk here.
Sorry, Mr. Harrison, a fair one out. What's so special about Mr. Ismay's ships, then?
Luxury, James. That's the mark of the White Star line. Luxury and elegance. But the better sort expected, Mr. Ismay provides it.
And that's why they're going to build them bigger still.
Where'd you hear that, James?
Over dinner. Before the gentleman retired to talk, his lordship was talking about the largest dry dock in Belfast. Enormous gantries, a dry dock built for a ship that hadn't even been built yet.
The footman who is in service, he keeps to himself, James.
Sorry, Mr. Harrison, he didn't say anything precise. I was merely speculating.
You may have speculated more accurately than you realised.
I did.